What up, Transformer fans? Set my Prime still asleep. We have it still. 9:50. Yep. Not mine. So, today we're going to do a review of Megatron, Quick Speed, my version of a, like, G1 version of that monster, but who knows, it's just my demonstration. And then, Plasma Beat, second version, then, more like the, Dark and Moon Laser Beak. Pretty cool, right? So, I shall start off with the smallest, which would be Plasma. He does have a flight mode, a flightning mode, like this. So, he does have that. My version of Plasma Beak, I don't think there is it. No, height and real Plasma Beak. So, he's got a sword tail to help him out when he's battling. So to transform him, I just want to twist his mirror end around. So he should look like that. Then rotate her body, or well, his body around. So, I'm thinking kind of tired still. But you know, I take its wings, bring them to the beat. It should look like her eyes. It's eyes. Alright, then you got tank right there. This is its tail and its little beacon inside under the tail. As you can see under there. So you got a sword-ended tank. Put that right back here. Then we got all in vehicle mode right now. Because I thought that one was the easiest one out of my pack. So let's start with our leak now. I'm saying the Megatron for that. So he's the same jet as he was in the toy, so you just want to have them like that, pop up its head, let's take the back wings with it, which would become its, her wings, I think it's a she, then bring down the legs and then the feet, then you have a weird looking laser beak, right? That's why I put it like this now. And then make it squat. So it's like that. Kind of looks like a dodo with the long legs. So get that one out of the way. Same with this one. Now I want to Demolisher. Hard to compare those two. These two. They are both in the Deluxe class, and he's kind of in the Voyager. So, got Demolisher right here. Does have that scooping shovel. So, You just want to hold that someone. Like that. And that. Then bring out the arms. Bring the legs out. Rotate them both. By the legs. Then you got the Demolisher to hit actual leg walk move instead of wheel walk. His treads become this part of his leg. So I am kind of tired still, so my voice is kind of cracky. Even though I still got no voice yet. So, he is a pretty good poser. Can bring a shovel up past his head to give him like a rain shield mode. Oh, that mode. Pretty good. I might have just checked him out, probably. So, there he is. Put him beside the
See?
Yeah. His beak's more of a scalp class. They do have all bio and a transformation skill bioracle. So you see this? This says quick tread. He needs a third tread, but I gave him two. It's pretty cool. Because he's more like a snow tank or something. Snowmobile. Futuristic kind, I should say. So, to transform him, he is one of my hardest. The Lux classes. So, you got that leg like that. Bring down that. Rotate it. Bring that down. Rotate it. Then you should get a walking chest. Then, what you're gonna do? I had this thing locked in, the skull locked into the peg, so it plucked off. And then you have my nose now. Bring out the sure, whatever. So you should get that from the skirt armor too. Then what you wanna do? You wanna rotate the head up. This is my favorite part. Yep, rotate the body. This chest becomes like the shield to plug his arms in. Then tighten basically his arms off. And then bring out the blades. Then bring out the head. All figures that I have right now have different heads. So, you should get this guy. He has not had, he doesn't have wrists or hands. He's just got blades. So he's like, he got Baraka sword. He turns out to be the same height of the Demolisher. I'm not quite sure of that, so let me get him out. Board standing mode. And thing He actually is higher because he has like that neck, and he doesn't. His arms are higher than his head, so if you get him out of the way, and it's a finale that you guys have all been waiting for. Normally, I think it's a spell, but so he got Megatron. Yep, he's a fat tank. And I think he just turned dead. So, what you want to do is take off the tank cannon, which is going to become his hand in robot mode. Well, not his hand, but his weapon. So, you just want to bring out the arms. And this little peg right here, or this little thing right here, I'm going to keep this guy for a body. And so, he's going to have a mini kind of go with him. So then you got that. Bring up his arm straight out. And then you should see the thing. So. He was gonna be more like the DLF. Wait. Yeah, WFC. War for Cybertron. Like, but I used those two pieces to give him the cred beat. So then. Bring out that. Look at him right now. So I'm going to be face to face to the camera, okay? So, I have my arms where the hole is facing upward, so he's got a bigger elbow joint. It says this elbow joint. It's all humans can do this. So, obviously, Transformers can do that. That's what I have to say about that part. And then you get the tank cannon. Just plug it into here. It becomes his tank cannon. So it's got that GM look. Cool. I've made some gun Megatrons before, but I have to say, this is the best Megatron I've made so far. He's nothing compared to my Jetfire. He's too good. I gotta say, he is kind of in the void. Time to get my Bonsai Tron. Come in one. This guy's like me because I got like scared when I was in that room. Don't you yell at me or don't make bad comments. I just heard a very, very creepy noise and it didn't appear up on the voice camera. So he's bigger than a Voyager, but he is kind of good. He's not the size of a leader class base, but I'm gonna get my this time now. He's in that same book bag as my bag. I'm in the book bag and he